I dreamed about that Formula One when I was 10. Since then, I had great memories and many, many great friends in the Formula One. Of course, in the Formula One, it's such a competitive world. You know, it's difficult to making friends in terms of just the drivers to driver, of course, in time. But still, you know, I have a great teammates all the time and fantastic memories. But when I come to the Indy 500, actually in qualifying day, I stood inside Turn 1. The car's coming in 235 miles per hour in average. And going to the corner, the driver actually driving it. I mean, the car's actually, you can see the slip angle on the car. That was so impressive. Coming from Formula One, about speed, I wouldn't think I was surprised, but I was really shocked. And then I got really interested. And after that, it was a great opportunity with Jimmy Vassar, gave me a first opportunity to IndyCar. It's not the Formula One, but you can't really directly compare because the actual action on track is unbelievable. You know, so competitive, and I'm really enjoying the IndyCar series as well as, of course, now winning one Indy 500, one of the pinnacle of the racing event. So, yeah, it was a long journey, but I gotta thanks and I gotta really appreciate the time in the Formula One. Of course, first AD Jordan gave me the great opportunity, and now finding another competition world in the States. Honestly, I'm so proud of the one of the Honda program. The relationship started from the actual racing school. So when I was 20, 21, I got a scholarship. That's how really ending up in here too. And being Japanese, of course, you know, having a Honda engine is a special feeling. The technology is the latest and advanced in the Formula One in the world. I remember back in 2002, the first time ever, you know, as a Formula One regular driver, working with Honda properly in highest level, that was such an experience. Looking at this, it's a very classical. It's almost retro, because everything has to be manual. Love to hear the high pitch, high tone nose, you know. Back in days when I was driving, of course, 3-liter V10 is screaming at 19,000 RPM. That was an unbelievable engine, but great people and commitment still continue to work together. Now Toro Rosso and Honda look like a great pairing, and I hope, you know, wishing the obviously the best of the luck for the rest of the season as well as a great future for them.